Hey guys, it's Aaron. And as of this recording, SketchUp for Desktop 2025 just released, and I want to tell you my five favorite new features. This is actually a tough one this year because it's probably been said elsewhere, but I feel like this is the most feature-packed release that SketchUp has had maybe ever. In terms of things like, this is a SketchUp model right behind me. It doesn't look like a SketchUp model. It looks like something that got rendered, but it's not. This is just SketchUp. So you saw the ability to run SketchUp just like you did before. If I want to work with just plain white faces and shadows or whatever, I can work with that style, but I can also work in something that has much deeper, richer, but I'm getting ahead of myself. Point is, there was a lot of good stuff in this release, and I had to carve it down to five things that I like the most. And it was tough. I left some things out. We have other videos going out. Matt did a video that ran through all the release notes and had everything, but these are my top five. Let's take a look at what they are right now. All right, number one is not actually a feature, but it is an extension that is available. And that extension is right here, extensions, migrate extensions. What migrate extensions will let you do is grab an old version of SketchUp that you have installed and actually see the extensions that are in that version that aren't in the current version. So what this lets you do is in a click, you can come through here and get all of your extensions installed. So in the past, I have definitely been quite vocal about saying that, no, I don't want all my extensions to just migrate over. I like the process of going through, going to Extension Warehouse and see which ones did I use, which ones am I missing, what features do I need, and then kind of bringing them on, because I end up with extension bloat. I end up with too many extensions installed, and being able to pick and choose which ones to bring over is super helpful for me. The nice thing about this, the migrator, is it actually lets you choose which one you want to bring over. So it'll bring you up a list, it'll say which one of these do you want to bring in, and you can pick and choose which ones to bring, which ones to leave behind. It's amazing, and that's why it is number five in my top five list. All right, number four is kind of a funny one. This is probably something a lot of people will overlook, not notice, or maybe not even care about, but it is some changes to the rotate tool. You guys have seen me use rotate a lot. I like to do things like I use rotate to make copies and to mirror things before the flip command was in there, but I still like it. I use it a lot when I'm modeling, and some things change with this version. So one is I have the handles. So see that by default when I bring this up, I have center handles so I can center or rotate off the middle. So that's in addition to things like the corner points or midpoints of edges, that kind of thing. And actually, just like I have a modifier key, just like in Move, where I can actually tap and get the different spots to rotate from. So here's the center of the component that I can go off of, corners, edges, middle of edges of sides, then the middle of each edge, and then back to the center. So I have those snaps in there, which is super cool. The other thing that shows up is these little handles right here. These are normally in here, so when you go to Move, right, when you click on Move in something, you automatically get these handles. There's an option to toggle them off on Move if you don't like seeing them there. I've always liked this because something like this, where I don't necessarily want to rotate off a corner, these handles let me move about the center, which was really nice, but it was only in Move. So now in Rotate, I have the ability to pick a point to rotate, and I can choose what direction I want to rotate as well, red, green, blue, or if I want to set an axis to rotate, or I can just come up here and hover over a handle, and I get that same functionality where I can just go right off of that point and then rotate there. It's a little thing, it's I guess a quality of life, less clicking kind of thing, but the fact that they've taken a command that I use so much, I like using rotate so much, and made it so much easier to work with, that's why that's number four on my list. Makes that so much easier to move. I get even more out of rotate. For number three, we're gonna hop over real quick into layout. Layout is something that layout has actually gotten a lot of attention. There's a lot of things in layout that are better. Performance stuff also, you know, hooks up to the new visualization. There's a bunch of things that happen in here in Rotate, but again, I'm a simple guy. But the things that I like so much are the way that the modification tools have changed. So I'm talking about move, rotate, scale. Move, for example, if I come in here, I pick this and then I hit move, I have the ability to use the same modifier keys that I use over in SketchUp. So I can say I want to copy to make a copy of it. Or if I want to stamp, I hit the modifier key twice, and now I'm stamping these things into place. This is the kind of stuff that I just feature parity between the two programs, Layout and SketchUp, is so cool, because Layout is starting to work more and more like SketchUp does, the inferencing, and now the modifier tools the tools with the modifier keys. This kind of stuff is so nice. So rotating in the old one, you would select. I should point out that the old tools are still here. So if I want to scale or rotate using the grips that I'm used to in Layout, I can do that. But if I'm used to SketchUp, I can click on the rotate tool, and then I can say rotate it just like I would inference and rotate like I would in SketchUp. Scale works the same way. I have the inferencing tool, so I can actually pull off of corners and stuff like that. Just so nice to have what feels like the exact same tools in both programs. So that's why that's number 3 on my list. All right, we got 2 more that I want to take a look at, and they are both very closely connected. So I'm going to back up here and look at something. It's very noticeable if you're a SketchUp user. I actually have a sky dome going on. So the sky dome is that 360 degree sky that's all the way around, which is awesome in and of itself. But the cooler part is that it is actually connected to lighting. So you can see here as I'm rotating this back and forth, see that shimmer? That light that just flickers and plays across the roof of my building, that is the environment, and that is the lighting that comes from it. So over here we have this new panel called environments, and it lets me do a lot of things. I can choose to have a different environment, which is gonna set this in a different thing. And you can see, not only does that change the sky dome, I should probably come in here and let me go turn off my ground plane real quick. That's why it's covering up some of the goodness. There we go. And then back into environments. And you can see as I click through here, again, not only is it changing that sky dome, but if you look, see the colors are actually changing on the model. That is all an effect of environments. And I did a whole separate video on this. We'll be going deeper into this in different videos, but I can actually change things in here. I can change, you know, where does that light come from? How does that sky dome hit on there? Just amazing stuff that makes it so nice to work inside SketchUp. SketchUp functions exactly the same as it did before. It just looks that much better without having to go to render or anything like that. I get a nicer, cleaner looking, not to talk down rendering. Rendering still has its place, absolutely. I'd still mind take this over into a renderer or take it into V-Ray and get some photoreal shots out of it. But as I'm modeling, I can actually see closer representation of what this would look like in the real world. And that is why the lighting and the environments is my number 2 spot. Which of course brings us to the ultimate spot, the final spot, the number 1 spot. And that is, you probably already noticing it, these awesome, amazing looking materials. So if I come in here, let's go drop down here and look at this brick right here. No, you know what? Let me do this. I'm gonna change to a more extreme lighting environment. So let's go ahead and hop over here and get something where I got I want a warm light. I want something to just hit this thing and light it on up. I guess we look at this right here. Look at the roof right here. See how this is changing right here? That's because of, yes, the environment, but the environment is playing off the actual material of the roof. So if I come in here and drill down into this material right here, I can actually change and edit that material. So if I bring up my paint bucket, I'll get my colors window. And I'm, of course, on the Mac UI. The Windows UI is going to look very similar, but of course, you know, window-y-er. So if I look at the material that's on here, let's see, let's pick it. All right, so that's this material right here. You can double click on it. And this material, I can actually change the material, how it works. So I can change the metalness, how reflective is it, if it has a roughness. In something like bricks, I can look at my normal map and ambient occlusion. I can actually take this material and change how it interacts with the environment around it while inside SketchUp. So if I have something like a brick, let's go, I'm gonna make something to look at. So I'm just gonna draw a rectangle right here. I'm gonna draw two rectangles right here. And then I'm gonna throw some brick material in here. So I'm gonna come here, go into my brick, and I'm gonna drop some brick right on here. And then maybe I'll go grab a nice reflective metal and put that on here. And what that's gonna let me do is, as I flick that around, look at that, look at how that, see how that plays? So here on the brick, I get a change in light as I go across, but I don't get a reflection because it's brick and it's, you know, it's bumpy and it's flat, but the metal here is shiny. So as I do that, I don't just get light reflecting, I actually get the environment. Look at that. I can actually see the trees and the grass in the sky dome reflected behind me. And this is just the tip of the iceberg. Like I said, I'm just showing you what it is. But this right here is why my number one spot for SketchUp 2025 is these PBR materials, these better than ever materials, and how I can still use, I keep hitting the B button instead of space bar. That's me. That's not, I can't blame software on that one. But these materials are why they are my number one. Look at that. Look how cool that looks. Look at the material playing, that light playing across material. But those materials are my number one aspect, my number one new feature in 2025. So like I said, it was hard to bring that list down to only five. There's so many more things that I like about this new version, but those five were, you know, after consideration, those are the big ones. Those are the ones that I'm going to be geeking out on. So as we do our weekly live streams here on YouTube, come check that out. You'll see more of this stuff that we're doing right here. More of these features, and of course we'll be putting videos out every week showing, you know, for a little while here, it's going to be focused really on how you can use these new tools to make the best looking SketchUp models you've ever made. If you like that video, click like down below, and if you haven't already, please do subscribe. We create several videos each and every week, and be notified of all of them if you subscribe. Most importantly though, the most important thing, leave us a comment down below. Have you installed 25 yet? Do these features make you consider upgrading or purchasing a license? And if so, if you have, did I miss something? Is there another feature that you think is better than my five? Because I'd love to hear about that too. If you have an idea of a feature that you think we would make a good video, tell us about that too. We like making these videos a lot. We like even more when they're showing something you want to see. Thank you.